This video tutorial I will cover the difference between constructor injection and setter injection. Spring supports two types of injection. First one is setter injection and the second one is constructor injection. Setter injection uses setter and getter methods for injecting the values. Constructor injection uses constructor for injecting the values. Both injection has their own pros and cons that we will see now. In setter injection, partial injection is possible. Here you can see the class test. It has three dependencies, int, float and long. Suppose if you are not injected values for these dependencies, then it will take default value. In case of constructor injection, partial injection is not possible, because we cannot call the constructor without the matching parameters. Here using setter injection, value 1 is set as 10 and value 2 and value 3 is not setted. And if you run the main class, we will get this output. For value 1, we will get 10 because we have set as 10. For value 2 and value 3, we will get default values. If we have more number of dependencies in our class, then setter injection is not advisable. Let's say we have 15 properties in our class. Then we need to write 15 getter and setter methods. It will increase the size of the bean. In those cases, constructor injection is the best option. Setter injection overrides the constructor injection. Suppose we have a property and property value is injected via setter injection and the constructor injection. In that case, setter injection will take the precedence and setter injection will override the constructor injected value.